Greetings. This is a continuation of our CO, analyze the handling characteristics of vehicle based on lateral dynamics. In our today's session, what is our learning objective is analyze the handling characteristics of two-axle wheel while negotiating a curve at a higher or moderate speed under steady state condition. A steady state handling performance is concerned with the directional behavior of a vehicle during a turn under non-time varying conditions. An example of a steady state turn is a vehicle negotiating a curve with constant radius at a constant forward speed or constant velocity of vehicle. In the analysis of steady-state handling behavior, the inertia properties of the vehicle are not gonna concerned, because when a vehicle is negotiating a turn at moderate or higher speeds, the effect of the centrifugal force, that is the inertia force arising from the normal component of acceleration towards the center of the turn, that is acting at the center of gravity, can no longer be neglected. So to balance the centrifugal force, the tires must develop the appropriate cornering forces against the force in lateral direction, As we discussed in our previous sessions, the side force must acting on the tire produces a side slip angle. So, when a vehicle is negotiating a turn at moderate or high speeds, the four tires will develop a appropriate slips or appropriate slip angles, To simplify the analysis, as we discussed in low speed turning, the four tires considered as a two wheels, like front two wheels lumped as a single tire and rear two wheels lumped as a single tire. Totally, we have two axles and two tires, one wheel at front, another wheel at rear. So we can call it as bicycle model because it has only two wheels. These two wheels, which gives the handling characteristics of any four wheelers, But in our low speed turning analysis, we didn't consider any slip angle because the slip is very, very less. But at higher or moderate speed of vehicle, there is a significant amount of slip will create at the vehicle or vehicle tires. So it is important to consider the slip angles which is generated at the tires because of the lateral force during the turn of vehicle. So here we are going to analyze the four wheeler negotiating a turn at higher speeds. So as we discussed, I am just converted the four wheelers into bicycle model. Here I am going to take right turn. If we consider two wheel steering at front, it gonna create some steering angle at front only. If we consider four wheel steering, there will be a steering angle at front and rear. For easy understanding, I am going to consider a front wheel steering, So the front wheel will create some steering angle which can be mentioned del F. Before taking a turn, the vehicle will move in this direction along. It may be mentioned as we discussed, this is a longitudinal direction X, this is a lateral direction Y, which is from left to tire to right tires, So this is a longitudinal direction. Before taking a turn, the vehicle will move in this direction, but after taking a turn, the vehicle will move some steering angle direction. It may be indicated as del f because front wheel steering geometry. Okay, so during front wheel steering it creates some steering angle which may be mentioned as del f, right? Okay, so as we discussed, there will be some amount of slip angle will occur, or slip occur at tires because of the lateral force generated at the tires. So the slip occurs at front, maybe in this direction. Listen clearly, this direction is much important during solving of or analysis of any problem, right? The slip angle occurs in this direction, right? In left hand side, this may be mentioned as alpha f. Slip angle generally mentioned as alpha, so front wheel or slip angle may be mentioned as alpha f. So at the rear it creates a slip angle because of lateral force, this may be mentioned as alpha rear. So because of slip angle there we saw some amount of lateral force during the turn, so it will be opposite to the slip angle, it will be in right hand side, right? It may be downward because looking at the plan view or top view of a vehicle, right? So it can be mentioned as F because of force in lateral direction, that is why it is because of slip angle at rear, may be mentioned as alpha R. Right, so F Y R, it is a lateral force because of slip angle at rear. So at this point, it must be mentioned perpendicular to the tire, right? So this is not a correct way, so it will be like this, right? It will be like this, right? So F Y, because of lateral direction force at front, FIF. So FIF and FIR are same, maybe, right? Okay. So as we know that the distance between rear to front may be indicated as wheel base, generally indicated as caps L, right? So we have a CG point maybe at here, so the distance between CG and front tire may be indicated as LF, and distance between rear and CG may be indicated as LR. As we discussed in low speed turning, when there is a movement in lateral direction, there is some amount of slip will create at the vehicle axis, so the vehicle move in this direction, this slip may be indicated as beta, right? So beta is beta, and there is some amount of yaw rate, that is generally mentioned as yaw is gamma. So we already discussed this beta and gamma lot and lot in low speed turning. So gamma is a yaw rate moment in our along x direction of this is a yaw which creates which will create in along z axis, right? Okay, our moment about z axis, that is gamma, right? So it can be converted into force. For clear understanding, I just redrew the bicycle model of vehicle at a higher speeds. Okay, this is a rear tire, this is a front tire. While I am steering of front tires, it creates some amount of steering angle, that is del f, because of movement it creates some higher speed movement, it creates some amount of slip angle at front in this direction, just arrowed here, right? So at rear it creates some amount of slip angle, right? So which is a direction of like this, right? Alpha, because of slip angle there is some amount of lateral force in y direction, right? So that is FYR and FYF. So the wheel base is L, distance between CG and front is LF, CG and rear is LR. At CG point of vehicle, there is some amount of slip of vehicle. That slip angle of vehicle can be mentioned as beta. There is some amount of it is a moment about z axis, right? So there is a forward velocity x, lateral velocity y, right? Okay. So the total amount of force in lateral direction is FYF plus FYR, which creates some amount of turning radius of turning radius, that is mentioned as caps R, right? I repeat, this lateral force FYF and FYR, which creates a turning, the turning force we generally called as MV squared divided by R. M is a mass of vehicle, V velocity, it can in a forward direction, right? So R is a turning radius, right? So turning radius is imaginary, so which is by using a imaginary line or extended line we can get R. We already discussed about this, right? So FYF plus FYR equal to MV squared divided by R. What is our second expression is a moment. So we have a FYR in downward direction and FYF in downward direction. That is two lateral forces, right? So we can take a moment at the point of CG, right? So we get FYF into a distance LF. LF is a distance between CG and front tire, right? So FYF into perpendicular distance LF, which creates a right side clockwise moment, and FYR into perpendicular distance to FYR is LR, which creates negative or anti-clockwise moment. So FYF we take it as positive and anti-clockwise direction we take it as negative. FYR into LR equal to zero, our moment about point CG. Now I am going to use again along with geometry, right? I repeat, now I am going to use the dynamic along with geometry again, right? Okay, because in order to calculate the del or delta F, we have to study the geometry in detailed view, right? Okay, you have got confusion with beta. This is a slip angle which creates a CG point of vehicle. This slip angle creates in vehicle while moving in lateral direction. There is a slip angle at rear wheel, there is a slip angle at front wheel, there is also slip angle at vehicle CG point. This slip angle is generally indicated as beta. So beta is a slip angle of vehicle. Angle of vehicle, don't confuse with a slip angle of tires. That is a slip angle of tire is alpha F at front, alpha R at rear, right? So now look at this triangle. We have a X forward velocity and beta slip angle, right? And Y lateral velocity, right? So tan beta equal to, you know that tan theta equal to opposite divided by adjacent. That is opposite Y and adjacent is X. So tan beta equal to Y by X. This is our third derivation. One, this is our second, and this is our third. Now we have calculated tan beta. Now we have to calculate the tan alpha R. For that we have to consider the velocity of rear tire, right? Okay. We know the velocity of vehicle in longitudinal direction is x and lateral direction is y, right? The same thing our tire is going to get in a longitudinal direction, going to get x velocity. In lateral direction there is same y velocity. In downward direction we are looking from the top, sorry for the inconvenience, right? Okay, now you get a point here, there is some amount of air at CG, right? Okay, because of the air, the velocity in lateral direction is going to change at the rear, right? So there is some amount of lateral velocities is going to present at rear because of air. So what is the velocity going to get is R into LR. That is what it is going to get. It going to rotate in clockwise direction. So the velocity will be in upward direction because of air. So the velocity is BR. So now look at this triangle. At this point it is going to be in x direction, right? In upward direction there is BR, right? BR. In downward direction there is y. So we can write it as this is upward, then this downward, BR minus y, lateral velocity, right? So longitudinal velocity x, lateral velocity is in upward direction BR. So I draw the triangle here of rear wheel triangle. Please listen carefully, you can't get this answer in your book, right? So in x direction there is this forward velocity, in y direction BR minus y. So it is going to create some triangle using alpha r. So our tan alpha r, which is equal to opposite divided by adjacent. Opposite is BR minus y divided by x. So maybe mentioned small, right? So tan alpha r equal to BR minus y. So I repeat, look at here, we need to get a velocity of rear wheels in order to calculate tan del r, right? So we know that our forward velocity is x and lateral velocity is y of y in vehicle. So we have to calculate the forward velocity and lateral velocity of rear wheel as well as front wheel, right? So first we take it as rear wheel. So in rear wheel we had get x forward velocity, but in lateral direction there is some velocity change at rear wheels because there is some amount of air at CG point. Because of this air there is some amount of velocity in lateral direction, so that velocity is BR, which is in upward direction because of rotation is clockwise direction. Look here, so the rotation is like this, right? So there is some amount of velocity in lateral direction at rear wheels, which will be in upward direction. So there is always some amount of lateral velocity, which is y, in downward direction. So the total lateral velocity is BR minus y, right? So let us take a triangle of this rear wheel. So it creates x forward velocity, in y direction BR in upward and y is downward, so BR minus y in upward direction. So I just zoom in the triangle at rear wheels, right? So x in forward or longitudinal direction, BR minus y in lateral direction in upward, right? So tan alpha r, which is tan theta equal to opposite divided by adjacent. So our opposite side is BR minus y, adjacent side is x. So tan alpha r equal to BR minus y divided by x, right? Okay, so we have to calculate tan alpha f like this. The same function, we have to calculate the tan alpha f, sorry, here I am going to change some notations. Listen the notations carefully. Here I just used LR not B, so the lateral velocity is not BR. This is actually LRR, right? So if we take our triangle here, instead of BR we get LRR, right? Here to LRR, right? Don't confuse with it. Okay, so I explain again. So because of yaw at the CG, there is some amount of change in lateral velocity at rear. Because of yaw at CG, I repeat, right? So there is no change in forward velocity, that is longitudinal velocity. Always change in velocity of lateral direction, that is why we get LRR at rear, right? Okay, so instead of B, I wrongly wrote the notations, right? Okay, so instead of B, I just mentioned LRR. Okay, here to LRR. So our tan alpha R equal to LRR minus Y, right, divided by X, which is actually in negative direction, right? So you see here the alpha R creates in this direction, right? Alpha F2 in this direction. There is no not in positive direction of right hand, it creates in left hand direction. So I just mentioned as minus. So minus of LRR minus Y divided by X. This is our fourth equation. I just trying to simplify our tan alpha R here. So we know that tan alpha R equal to minus of LR into R minus Y whole divided by X. So tan alpha R equal to Y by X minus LR into R divided by X. So tan alpha R is very small, so alpha R we take it as we know that Y by X in our equation number 3, Y by X equal to tan beta. Tan beta is very small, so we take it as a small beta and minus of LR divided by R divided by X. So we know that V equal to R omega, right? This is our known value. So what we have here, instead of V, we have a forward velocity X. Instead of omega, we have a R at R. So instead of R, we have turning radius R, going to turn, right? So what we require here is R divided by X. So R by X, which is equal to 1 by R, right? So alpha R equal to LR divided by caps R. I repeat, what we have done here is we know that V equal to R into omega. V is forward velocity, R is radius of turn or radius, whatever. Omega is angular velocity. So what we have here is the forward velocity or linear velocity is X, that is longitudinal direction velocity, which is equal to radius of turn is caps R. Our angular velocity we have R it, right? Okay, so X equal to R into R. What we require here is R by X. So I just brought the X here and R this side. So R by X equal to 1 by R. I just substitute this value of R by X equal to 1 by R here. So we get alpha R equal to beta minus LR divided by R. This is our equation number 5. Now we have calculated alpha R value. As well as we calculated alpha R, we have to focus on alpha F, right? So now there is no change in forward velocity X. There is a change in or variation in lateral velocity That is why, because of yaw at CG pad. This yaw creates some changes in lateral velocity, right? So here, what is the velocity change is, instead of y, we get LR into R minus y, because it creates clockwise direction of yaw, right? So the lateral velocity is LR, that is our distance, into our yaw R, so in upward direction. But at front wheels, when looking from the rear, it creates in the R, creates in clockwise direction, so our variation of lateral velocity is LF, that is our distance, LF into R, yeah, right, LF R plus Y, because when looking from rear, it creates the yaw in clockwise direction, so the lateral velocity change in front wheels will be in downward direction, so our lateral velocity here is LFR plus Y. Already we have a forward velocity, that is our X, we have a del F angle here and alpha F angle here, right? So now we are going to calculate the tan alpha F, right? Here I just focus the front wheel triangle. So at front wheel we get X forward velocity and del F steering angle and alpha F slip angle. So our tan alpha F, we know that this is our lateral velocity, LFR plus Y. This is our forward velocity or linear velocity X, right? So tan alpha F equal to, you know that opposite divided by adjacent. So our opposite side is LFR plus Y, adjacent side is X. But what is the major problem here is our steering angle del F. So steering angle del F in this side, that is a right hand side or clockwise rotation, and alpha F is anti-clockwise rotation, so del minus alpha F. So alpha F is LFR plus Y divided by X. So we know that alpha is F in anti-clockwise direction, we just mention as minus. So minus of del F plus LFR plus Y by X, right? So we know the value of Y by X and R by X, minus del F plus R by X, we know that 1 by R we have calculated in our rear wheel triangle, and Y by X in from our equation number 3, we get beta, right? So our tan the alpha F or alpha F equal to minus del F plus LF divided by R plus beta. So this is our equation number 6. From equation 5, so our equation 5 is alpha R equal to beta minus LR divided by R, right? So from equation number 5, beta equal to alpha R plus LR divided by R. This is our equation number 7. Apply 7 in 6, we get alpha F equal to minus del F plus LF divided by R plus alpha R plus LR divided by R. I just rewrite this equation, del F minus del F plus alpha R plus LF plus LR divided by whole divided by R. So we know that LF plus LR, LF is a distance from CG to front, LR is a distance from rear to CG, right? So I just saw it, saw this in geometry. In our geometry, LF, this one, LR, this one. So LF plus LR equal to wheelbase, that is L, right? So we can simplify that L equal to LF plus LR. So we simplify this equation, alpha F equal to minus del F, right? Minus del F plus alpha R plus L by R. What we need here is del F, right? That is what we are going to calculate. So del F equal to, F equal to, just bring this here and alpha F this side. So L by R plus alpha R minus alpha F, right? I rewrite that equation here. Del F equal to L by R plus alpha R minus alpha F. This is a one type of equation. This may be indicated as eighth equation. Or in other hand, it can be write as del F equal to L by R plus alpha F minus alpha R. That is a positive and negative sign changes. In anticlockwise, clockwise rotation of yaw, it can be rewrite whatever it may be, right? So generally we used to pick this equation, right? So that is easy for us to calculate. So del F equal to L divided by R plus alpha F minus alpha R. Now come again to our second equation, that is Fy alpha into LF minus Fyr into LR equal to 0. So Fyf equal to Fyr into LR divided by LF is our equation number 10. And our equation number 1, that is Fyf plus Fyr equal to mv squared divided by r. So we know that Fyf equal to Fyr into LR divided by LF. Apply this, apply equation number 10 in 1. So we get Fyr into LR divided by LF plus Fyr equal to mv squared divided by r. So take it out, Fyr equal to LR divided by LF plus 1 equal to mv squared divided by r. From here, Fyr into LR plus LF divided by LF equal to mv squared divided by r, because LF is multiplied with 1 and LR plus LF divided by LF, right? Okay, so Fyr equal to mv squared divided by r into LF divided by LR plus LF, right? So we know that LF plus LR equal to L, so mv squared whole divided by r into LF divided by L. I just consolidated what we have calculated of lateral force. Fyf equal to Fyr into LR divided by LF, and Fyr equal to mv squared by r into LF by L. This is what we have calculated at equation numbers 10 and 11. This is what we have calculated in equation number 10 and 11. You can check it out, right? Okay. And we know that Fy equal to C alpha into alpha, which may be in minus, right? So minus or plus, you can call it as whatever, because alpha will be in anti-clockwise direction, right? So we can mark it as minus, but most of the books you can see fi equal to c alpha into alpha. We just take it as what it is, maybe, right? Okay, so fi equal to c alpha into alpha, you know that. So fyf equal to c alpha f into alpha f, right? So fyr equal to c alpha r into alpha r, right? Already we have discussed this, you know, cornering properties of tires, right? So you can check it on the tire dynamics lectures, right? So fy equal to c alpha alpha, you know that. And fyf from this equation we can call it as c alpha f into alpha f. C alpha, which indicates the cornering stiffness, and alpha is slip angle, fy is lateral force. So lateral force at front equal to cornering stiffness of tires at front into slip angle of front wheels, and lateral force at rear FOR equal to cornering stiffness of rear wheel into slip angle of rear wheel, right? This is equation number 12 and this one 13, right? So you know that already in equation number 11, FOR equal to mv square divided by r into lf divided by l, and in equation number 13, FOR equal to c alpha r into alpha r. Equate these 11 and 13, so we get 11 equal to 13 c alpha r into alpha r equal to mv square divided by r into lf divided by l, right? So what we require here is alpha r, which is equal to m v square divided by r into lf divided by l into c alpha r. So now we take a wheelbase side of vehicle, so single line. This is a point at rear, this is a point of front. So the total load will be act at CG point, that is W. The distance between front to rear is LF. The distance between, the distance between front to CG is LF, and distance between CG to R is LR, that is a rear point, right? So what is the weight at equilibrium weight at here and here? This is WF and WR, right? So we just take a moment at WR, right? So WF, which is anti-clockwise direction, total length may be L. So WF equal to WF into, take a moment at a rear point, so WF into L, which is in anti-clockwise direction, may be plus or minus whatever. So I just take it as minus, and W into LR, right, which is clockwise direction to, so positive W into LR, which is equal to 0. So WF equal to WLR divided by L, right? So look here, W may be m caps mass into gravity, that is what W into LR divided by L, which is equal to WF, right? Look here. Here you can see in a fashion that alpha R. So instead of WF, we can calculate it for WR. So WR equal to caps or small mg LF by L. This is what you will get while solving this equation. So WR equal to mg into LF divided by L. Look this equation, alpha R equal to mv square divided by R LF divided by L into C alpha R. So look at this equation. So WR equal to mg divided by sorry, mg into lf divided by l, we just bring this g here. So wr divided by g equal to m into lf divided by l. So here you can look it at m into lf divided by l. It can be replaced by wr in divided by g. So alpha r we get here is alpha r equal to w r divided by g, right, into 1 by v squared divided by c alpha r into r, right? So I just replace this value by w r divided by g. You look here, right? I bring here, so this equation may be write as w r divided by g, which is equal to m l f divided by l. So w r by g, so w r divided by g into v squared divided by r divided by c alpha r, right? So alpha r equal to w r divided by g into turning radius caps r into v squared divided by c alpha r. I rewrite this for clear understanding. Alpha r equal to w r weight at rear divided by g into turning radius to v squared divided by c alpha r, right, carrying stiffness at rear wheel. So as well as alpha f, you can calculate w f divided by g into r v squared divided by c alpha f. You may be calculate this, right? This is our equation numbers. This is 14, this one 15. Apply 14 and 15 in, apply in 9. Our 9th equation is del f equal to l by r plus alpha f minus alpha r. So del f equal to l by r, alpha f is w f divided by g r v squared divided by c alpha f, right, plus w r divided by g r v squared divided by c alpha r, right? So you get common values, 1 divided by g r into v square, right? So we can simplify this equation based on that. Sorry, I made a mistake. This is not plus, this is minus, right? So common terms can be taken out, v squared gr common. So v squared divided by gr taken out, wf divided by c alpha f, right, minus wr divided by c alpha r. This is del f or del. So we can simply call it as del because of front wheel steering, but I just mentioned as del f from starting. So del or del f, whatever you may call this, right? So again I simplify this equation, del f or del whatever, right? So del equal to l by r plus v squared divided by gr. This v squared divided by gr is a lateral acceleration, a way can be replaced, and understeer gradient kus. So kus equal to wf divided by c alpha f minus wr by c alpha r. This is final answer of del equation number 16, right? So del is a steering angle, it may be in front. So l by r, you know that, plus v squared by gr can be expressed as lateral acceleration, that is ay, and kus is a understeer gradient. By using this only, we can tell that our steering is understeer or oversteer or neutral steer, whatever. So our kus, that is understeer gradient, is wf by c alpha f minus wr divided by c alpha r, right? I rewrite this clearly, c alpha r, right? Okay, so our del equal to del, that is our steering angle, equal to L divided by R plus KUS into AY. So L is wheel base, KUS understeer gradient, and AY lateral acceleration. And sorry, I forgot to mention the R, that is turning radius. So our del is one focus on wheel base and turning radius, weight of the vehicle, and cornering stiffness of tires. So these things are majorly plays with a steering angle, right? So I rewrite this KUS equal to F divided by C alpha F minus WR divided by C alpha R, right? And AY equal to V square divided by RG. So our steering angle is focused at the wheel base, turning radius R, weight at front and weight at rear, cornering stiffness of tire at front and rear, and velocity of vehicles. These things plays a major role in steering angle, right? By using this understeer gradient value, we can segregate our steering in three categories. Our steering may be neutral steer, or it may be understeer or oversteer. These three values of steering is calculated or identified or find by understeer gradient value, that is the difference between ratio of WF divided by C alpha F minus WR divided by C alpha R. These values plays major role in neutral steer, understeer, oversteer, our handling characteristics of vehicle, right? And this is the fundamental equation, right? This governs the steady state handling behavior of your own vehicle. It indicates that steering angle required to negotiate a given curve depends on the wheelbase, turning radius, forward speed or lateral acceleration, and understeer coefficient of vehicle, which is a function of weight distribution and tire cornering stiffness. Depends on the values of the understeer coefficient, that is KUS, or the relationship between the slip angles of the front and rear tires, the steady state handling characteristics may be classified into three categories, that is neutral steer, understeer, and oversteer. First, we take neutral steer. So in neutral steer, when the understeer coefficient, that is KUS, equal to 0, which is equivalent to the slip angles of the front and rear tires being equal, that is alpha F equal to alpha R, right? So WF divided by C alpha F minus WR by C alpha R equal to 0. So del F or del equal to L by R. So this is what we required while negotiating a turn or curve, right? Okay. A vehicle having this handling property is said to be a neutral steer. Its handling characteristics for a constant radius turn are represented by a horizontal line in steering angle speed. So that will be shown in diagram later. Okay. So for a neutral steer vehicle, so okay, I just shown a diagram here. This is the diagram I have mentioned. Del in y direction, velocity in the x direction, right? So if the understeer gradient KUS equal to 0, alpha f equal to alpha r, so that WF divided by C alpha f minus WR by C alpha r equal to 0, so the del or del f equal to L by r, which is shown in diagram. So the neutral steer will be del equal to L by r, will be in horizontal line, right? So it will be like straight line. Okay. For a neutral steer vehicle, when it is accelerated in constant radius turn, the driver should maintain the same steering wheel position. In other words, when it is accelerated with steering angle fixed, the turning radius remains the same, right? When a neutral steer vehicle originally moving along a straight line, it is subjected to a side force acting at the center of gravity. Equal slip angles will be developed at front and rear. Okay, that is alpha f equal to alpha r, that is what we mentioned before. As a result, the vehicle follows the straight path at an angle to the origin, right, as shown in this figure. So let us go for understeer, right? In understeer condition, the understeer coefficient is greater than 0, which is equivalent to the slip angle of the front tire alpha s being greater than that of rear tire alpha r, so that WF by C alpha f is greater than WR by C alpha r. The steering angle del f required to negotiate a given curve or turn increases with square of the vehicle forward speed, that is V squared by RG, that is a lateral acceleration, right? A vehicle with this handling property is said to be an understeer. So it is handling characteristics for a constant radius turn are represented by a parabola like this. So this is a parabola curve, right? Okay. So for an understeer vehicle, when it is accelerated in a constant radius turn, the driver must increase the steer angle. In other words, when it is accelerated with steering angle is fixed, the turning radius increases. So it is better to reduce the turning radius or fix the turning radius. So the driver must increase the steering angle, right? So as it is illustrated, right? So at the same steering wheel position and vehicle forward speed, the turning radius of understeer vehicle is larger than the neutral steer vehicle, so it is mostly preferred to increase the steering angle when the driver negotiates a turn in understeer conditions. When a side force acts at the center of gravity of understeer vehicle originally moving along a straight line in the front tires will develop a slip angle greater than that of rear tires, so that alpha f is greater than alpha r. So as a result, a yaw motion is initiated. So as we discussed earlier, the yaw motion is initiated, so the vehicle turns away from the side force as shown, right? So for an understeer vehicle, the characteristics speed, so it is the accepted value, so it may be mentioned like a characteristic speed is a root of g into L divided by KUS, right? So which is equal to the 2L divided by R, maybe 2L divided by R, which is equal root of GL divided by KUS equal to 2L divided by R. So I just mentioned here, right? Our next category, that is our third category, is oversteer. So in oversteer condition, our understeer gradient is less than 0, that is alpha f is less than alpha r. When the understeer coefficient KUS is less than 0, which is equivalent to the slip angle of the tire, that is alpha f is being less than that of rear tire alpha r, right? So that WF divided by C alpha F is less than WR by C alpha R. The steer angle del F required to negotiate a given curve decreases with increase of vehicle forward speed. That is a lateral acceleration. So that vehicle with this handling property is said to be a oversteer. This relation oversteer. This relationship between the required steering angle and the forward velocity for the kind of vehicle concentrated is turned may be like this, right? So this is creates some critical condition. So it is oversteer, right? It may be like this. Otherwise, it may be like this too. This if this is not possible, right? This may be your answer of oversteer. Okay, right. For an oversteer vehicle, when it is accelerated in a constant radius turn, the driver must decreases the steering angle. In other words, when it is accelerated with the steering angle is fixed, the turning radius will decrease, right? That is what possible in understeer case. The steering angle will increase when the it has to be increased when driver turn the steering wheel. It is opposite to the oversteer, right? So in oversteer condition, the turning angle will decrease when driver given input at a constant turning radius. For in other hand, for a change or a decrease in steering angle when driver given input, the turning radius will constant. For fixed steering angle, the turning radius will decrease in oversteer condition. That is what possible here, right? When a side force acts at the center of the gravity of the tire, originally moving along the straight lines, the front tires will develop a slip angle lesser than that of rear tires. That I mentioned here, alpha f is less than alpha r, right? As a result, yaw motion is initiated at the vehicle turns into the side force, right? So for an oversteer vehicle, a critical speed V critical can be identified because of oversteer. It is speed at which the steering angle required to negotiate any turn is zero, right? As shown in this equation, V critical is equal to root of GL divided by KUS understeer coefficient. Sorry, understeer gradient KUS, right? So I rewrite this formula, root of GL divided by KUS. You can see clearly here. It should be noted that for an oversteer vehicle, the understeer coefficient KUS in the above equation has a negative sign, right? It will be shown later that our critical speed will affect the steering property of vehicle. Here it may be like this. The critical speed also represents the speed above which an oversteer vehicle exhibits directional instability, right? That is why we are always following understeer conditions instead of oversteer. It will be better to have understeer in our vehicles, right? So in our passenger vehicles, that is always alpha f is greater than alpha r, and wf divided by c alpha is alpha f is greater than WR by C alpha R, and we get characteristic speed, and our graph will be like this in a parabola shape. So when our driver given input, the steering angle must be increases with input when we negotiating a turn for fixing the turning radius. Otherwise, if we fix the steering angle at a constant conditions, the turning radius may be increased. This is not advisable. So the steering angle will be increased when driver will give an input, right? Okay. So at oversteer condition, the prime factors controlling the steady state handling characteristics of a vehicle are the weight distribution of vehicle and the cornering stiffness of the tires. Okay. So at finally, we have calculated our understeer. Del equal to L by R plus V squared by RG. V squared by RG and WF divided by C alpha F minus WR divided by C alpha R. We just simplified this formula WR. Plus KUS into AY. By using these equations, we just we forwarded categorized steering into three: neutral steer, understeer, and oversteer. Most of these we just follow understeer condition because of characteristic speed, that is you see here root of G by L root of G by L whole divided by KUS, that is equal to 2L by R. We get a parabolic shape, so the turning radius should not be changed, so that the driver will give various or increased steering angle input, so that we can easily attain or easily negotiate the turn, right? I hope you can understand what I come to say. Thank you. At this point, our high speed cornering is over, right? Next we have to go for the different types of response, yaw velocity response, lateral acceleration response, and third one is curvature response. These three response comes under steady state response to steering input content, right? We can see that in our next sessions. Thank you.